Welcome to Let's Play Forza Motorsport 4 Part 86, and in this segment, I'm going to be driving another Bimmer. This time it is the Z3 M Coupe. Definitely not my favorite of the Z cars, but hey, you know. It's alright. Bought in yellow, because there wasn't really any good colors available for this, but anyways, that doesn't matter. What matters is we're going to upgrade this bitch to A-Class. And I guess we're going to put all this shit on it. And have us a grand old time. So, let's go race. I'm just going to race it as is. I might actually take some upgrades off if this ends up being too OP, but considering it's a 5-race series, I'm expecting it to be 5 very short races. So, here we go. Audi versus BMW Coupe Challenge. Limited to 2-door Audis and Bimmers. So, let's do this shit. Like I said, 5 races, so this ought to be interesting. And we go to Hockenheim to start off. Alrighty, here we go. It is Bimmer time, and also Audis. But Bimmer time! So, 2 laps around the Hockenheim Grand Prix circuit. Let's do this shit. Not a very good launch for me. A really good launch for Esposito. And we're going to go 4 wide into turn 1 almost. Oh boy. That scared me britches. Scared me out of my britches. MXGP2 can get a little touchy and glitchy. That sounds like pretty much every modern Milestone game, to be honest. That's the thing about Milestone games, like, they really interest me, and I'm probably going to, like, enjoy what I have played of Milestone's games, but they definitely aren't, like, great games. Like, they're good games at best. Some of them are probably mediocre, I don't know. Then again, the only really, like, modern Milestone game I've actually, like, played, and it was only for a very short time, was WRC4. But I really want to get, like, Milestone's just catalog games. Not just the car PGs they made in the PS2 era. Frickin' Alfa Romeo and Evolution GT and that truck racing game, which is basically Evolution GT with trucks. Stiff. I don't know. Like, Milestone's is one of those companies is like, I have a lot of interest in their games, but at the same time, I know they're like pretty mediocre. Like, just overall as a company. Also, I think I'm definitely downgrading this thing. Because, I have a 4-second lead after lap 1 here, so, yeah, downgrades are happening. They're absolutely happening. So it looks like 2, like, completely different cars from front to back. Like, front, it looks like a cool little sports car, and then the back, it's like, family wagon, yeah! Just a little confusing. It's just like, what the hell is this? So I like how in that fucking corner right above my left rear tire, paint is just gone. Like, the paint has just been completely stripped off in that little section. It's like, well then. Oh, another modern Milestone game I've played a little bit of, but it was just like the demo of Sebastian Loeb Rally Evo. So, there's that as well. I don't know. There's like way too many racing games across every fucking generation of gaming. I want to play them all, but I can't. And it makes me sad. It makes me a sad faggot. It's like, I want to play them all. I want to LP them all. I want it all. I want it now. And I get the win here. So, cool. Very, very dominant win, so yeah, definitely a downgrading this thing. And look at that full Bimmer sweep. Rossi in the fucking... holy shit. Look at that shit. A full sweep of Bimmers, alright. Well, I'm gonna wait to do the transition race too, because like I said, I'm gonna downgrade this thing, and I gotta show it on screen, so you know exactly what I do. Because, so let's just back out real quick, go to the upgrade shop, and I think I'm just going to take a little power off this thing, because it is quite wheel spinny, so let's go back to the stock fuel system, stock ignition, sure, stock valves. And stock filter. Alright, that'll work. Almost to race 2. Okay, here we go. Race 2 with my newly downgraded Bimmer. Let's see how this goes. At a Silverstone. The Silverstone. This is the international circuit. Can't remember if it's international or Grand Prix. I think it's international. It is international. Alright. I know, because map. Anyways. So far, doing adequate. Probably should be a little more aggressive on this pass on Weber, considering this is only a 2-lap race. So... probably actually try getting around him at in a timely fashion. You know, Mueller's going for the lead. So I believe Mueller's in the Unicorn car, the M3 GTR. Bastard! Both Rossi and Mueller have it, but not me, no. Gotta lock it behind some arbitrary, thing. I still don't like unicorn cars, if you haven't noticed. Anyways. Oh, shit. Okay. Careful with that curb. Alright. Oh, I... closing this gap on Rossi. How you doing? That's after reducing the power by like at least 50. I'm pretty sure I lowered it even more than that. God, F109. I'm on the fence about which version of F109 I want to eventually get, whether it be the PSP version or the Wii version. Is like either PSP or home console. Home console version might be a little better, but I'd have to deal with the Wii's motion controls. And I'm just like, I don't know. But then again, I'd be more accurate playing it on the Wii with like cornering and shit. I have played the PSP version because, hey, my PSP is modded, so I can just put a fucking ISO on it and go, but... interesting. It's just kind of that game that exists. It's like, I don't even know what to say about it. It's just like, Codemasters is like, alright, we have the F1 license right now, but we really don't want to like make a full-fledged game quite yet. Fuck it, just release it on PSP and Wii. Sure. And then they made F1 2010, and then that began the whole series. So yeah, in case you didn't know, F1 2010 is not the first Codemasters F1 game. It's just the first one worth mentioning, probably. Anyways, victory. Still a fairly easy victory, but not a large margin, so it works for me. Onwards to race 3. Okay, time for race 3. We are at the Top Gear circuit for the East course. And we're going the forward direction, so we're not starting right at Gambon. We're starting right at the exit of Gambon. Yeah, I have an ISO of F109, but I'm talking like, I would like to get like a physical, like, copy. If everyone actually, oh yeah, that's right, we're not doing like the full circuit. I don't have to adhere to those lines. Anyways, so yeah, if I got the PSP version, I want to actually get like a UMD. Even though it'd probably like be less efficient as far as like loading and stuff, and also a lot louder, because God, the UMD reading sound is fucking loud. But still, I'm very anal about actually owning physical copies of things on consoles. So, you know. That's why I actually bought UMDs of a few of the Need for Speed games on PSP. I mean, I have ISOs for them, and I have played most of Underground Rivals on an ISO, but gotta have the UMD, man. Gotta be legit. Anyways, another easy race here. I think it's just because my car handles too well. Like, I downgraded the power, but it still, you know, accelerates pretty well, and it also, you know, gets around the turns pretty goddamn well. So really, I downgraded it in the wrong spots to make this more competitive, is what I'm saying. Like, seriously, people, like, think fucking PS1 or Dreamcast disc reading is, loud. Fucking listen to a PSP reading a UMD. Shit's ridiculous. Anyways, just kind of dominating this race here. Thought I was going to miss Bacharach there, but nope. Actually got into it fairly well. And on to the final lap here. Kind of sad we're not doing the reverse of this course, because I, you know, flying across the line, just completely straight-lining Gambon and destroying the front of my car with no consequences. And all that jazz. Sure. Oh no, okay. Whoop, there we go, and victory. They released FIFA 14 on the PSP? Damn. Then again, you know, EA's... I think FIFA 14 was like the very last PS2 game to be released or something like that, so EA milking that shit for some reason. Anyways, there's race 3 done. 2 to go. Let's go to the next one. Okay, let's try this again and not absolutely destroy my car. That was just bad. Fucking really bad. It's just four-wheel slide right into the wall. Everything just died. So, Bernese Alps. Here we go for 2 laps around the medium length circuit. And a little bit better start this time, already up to 4th. That's good. That's good, that's good. And let's keep this together and stuff. Whoa. Hey, how you doing, Evans? How you doing, Evans? Oh, God. Come on, get that exit. Get that pass. Take that spot. Go that wide. Jesus. That's not what I was planning to do at all. Just kind of happened. Here's where I just kind of slid into the wall and died to death. Alright. Well, hello, Moore. You kind of lost all your momentum there. Oof. It almost looked like he hooked me there, but no, he didn't touch. It's just the car got oversteer. Alright, now to catch a pass for Rossi and his Audi TT. Cat barks at me. She wants more attention. Back here, Rossi. Can't get away from me. You can't run away from me. No one's going to get this reference. Because no one listens to fucking Brendan Small's Galacticon. Even though you should, because it's like one of the best albums ever made. It's my favorite album ever made. For now. For now. Be careful here, especially like Raher. And we make the pass. Got him. All right. Just gotta hold it through this little S, these little S's here, and into the final turn and all that jazz. And yeah. Get that late apex action going. And across the line. There we go. That's how you do it without crashing your car and dying to death. Hooray. So that leaves one race remaining in this. Hey, driver level up, nice. Sweet. Anyways, to the finale of this segment. Okay, what is this, attempt 4, 5, some, I don't fucking know. This is a hard race. And the only reason why it's hard is displayed on the top right corner of the screen. Two laps. Around Positano, reverse. Yeah, I have absolutely no time here. So let me just crash my way around everybody, because I ain't got time to waste. Which means I ain't got time to drive cleanly. This is the fifth attempt, okay. Hooray. Well, I at least got into second place in a timely manner, finally. Now let's close this gap on Rossi, hopefully make the pass and not crash while attempting to make the pass. And, yeah. Okay, here we go. Final lap. Hopefully. I mean, I've already done, like, 7 around here. Trying to win this race. 7 or 8. And there was a couple attempts that didn't make past lap 1, or, you know, obviously I never complete lap 2, so yeah. Don't worry, I'm not bad at math, I'm just thinking. Also, that kind of happened. It's not exactly how I expected or wanted to make the pass, but okay. That'll work, I guess. Yes, I have played NASCAR 06.
Total Team Control.
It's a very, very interesting concept, like, gameplay thing in 06 with the whole, you know, you can take control of your teammates' cars at any point during the race, except the final lap and when they're pitting. It's really neat. It's just like, hey, you can try to fabricate your own 1-2-3 finish. Or 4-1-2-3-4, full top 5 sweep for those certain size teams, like, you know, Roush and stuff. And hey, I finally won this damn race. That was ridiculous. Like I said, the difficulty lied within the shortness of the race. But there we go. There's the Audi versus BMW Coupe Challenge 1. BMW reigns supreme over Audi, because I said so. So there we go. That's our 46th event on the list down. Yeah. So, yeah. Stay tuned for the 47th.